Hello everybody and welcome to another War Thunder upcoming content video. This is one of two different devlogs that was released today on the 8th of December, and it's of a new jet aircraft, the F-15 Eagle, a new top-tier jet fighter that's going to be coming to three different nations for the game, the United States, Japan, and Israel. So let's take a closer look. It is a dedicated American air superiority fighter developed in the aftermath of the Vietnam War and based on the experience gained from it. Today we'll be talking exactly how this mighty jet will be when it comes to several nations in the air superiority major update. So as I said, it's the F-15 Eagle, and it's coming for Japan, USA, and Israel of the 8th rank for aviation, and it features that it is capable of Mach 2.3. It has excellent maneuverability, access to advanced ordnance, and of course countermeasures. Here's some history of the unit if you are curious to learn more about how it came to be. And then we have some screenshots of the aircraft with some different paint. Now I'm trying to see, I don't know what kind of paint, actually it looks like that's the paint it has in the video, never mind. So this is presumably the US F-15, I don't know if they show the other nations' F-15s here, but I do like that paint scheme, I like that blue and white. It's also actually something I don't say very often about jets of this era, but it is a nice looking jet, especially in comparison to the F-14, which I've notoriously always had a very bad, poor opinion of its visibilities. But let's see what else the F-15 has to offer. So soon to be arriving to the American, Israeli, and Japanese aircraft trees in the air superiority major update, the F-15 will become the new top dog of their respective trees, meaning you'll be offered with an unmatched combination of agility and speed coupled with lethal firepower. The first thing that they talk about here is its engine and performance. The F-15 is powered by a pair of Pratt & Whitney F-100 turbofan engines, generating an impressive thrust output confirmed by the F-15's top speed, which sits at Mach 2.3 at an altitude of 36,000 feet or 10,900 meters. Thanks to its extremely powerful engines, the F-15 possesses an excellent thrust-to-weight ratio, which allows it to quickly climb to altitude, but also to recover from energy-consuming dogfights much quicker. Furthermore, the F-15 features a more traditional fixed wing with low wing loading, unlike the F-14. This, plus its ability to generate lift with some sections of the fuselage, gives the F-15 truly incredible agility, despite its impressive size. As a result, the aircraft can perform very tight turns while losing only minimal energy in the process. This means if you enjoy the thrill of dogfighting in its purest form, you'll feel right at home while flying the F-15. As expected, the F-15 Eagle certainly has sharp claws. In general, its payload options are optimized for air combat, which is reflected in its impressive air-to-air missile armament, consisting of up to 4 short and 4 long-range missiles. Thanks to this, you'll be able to choose from a range of late AIM-9 Sidewinder and AIM-7 Sparrow missiles. For Japan and Israel, you'll have access to the additional option of outfitting the F-15 with respective domestic missiles, such as the AAM-3 or Python-3. Interestingly, during the mid-1980s, the F-15A was used as a launch platform for the experimental ASM-135 anti-satellite missile. Although the F-15 is optimized for aerial combat, it can certainly also pounce on prey found at ground level. Apart from conventional 500 and 2,000-pound bombs, as well as incendiary bombs, the American and Israeli F-15 can also carry up to 3 2,000-pound TV-guided bombs. Rounding off the Eagle's weapon options is the 20mm M61 Vulcan cannon, which can be used to devastating effect both against aerial but also surface targets in combination with computer-aided targeting and the appropriate ammunition. I do quite like when a jet of this type has access to some sort of cannon or pilot-controlled weapon that you can use, mainly because it just provides additional options for air realistic battles specifically, especially when strafing soft targets in that mode. And here is some shots of the aircraft, a nice side shot, a nice butt shot, and another side shot. So it doesn't look like we get to see any or the other versions of the aircraft here, at least not to see what their paint schemes look like. But so here's some tips for it. The addition of the F-15 is going to redefine the meta for top-tier air combat. It's fast, and it bleeds little speed thanks to its extremely powerful engines, but these must be handled responsibly. Remember that a large fuel load makes it physically impossible to do sharp maneuvers, which the F-15 is capable of at minimum load, so take care of your wings. It is simultaneously arriving at the top rank of three nations in the game when the next major update releases, and each F-15 will, of course, have its own camouflage depending on the nation. Well, then, gee, thank you for showing me here. The Japanese and Israeli ones aren't going to have this blue and white looking paint scheme for it. So, yay for that. Now, I don't know much about, like, this part of War Thunder personally. I don't have a lot of experience. I have very minimal experience with high-tier jet combat. But it doesn't seem like a lot of people are very happy in the comment section in regards to this. There seems to be a lot of issues with the F-15, or at least how they're representing it in the game. This seems to be very, what's the word here? Common with this update so far. I mean, I know that there is almost always some issue with what Gaijin does when they introduce new vehicles to the games. You know, sometimes it's just really minor inaccuracies or like an inaccuracy with the model or something like that, right? You know, nothing that's really super game changing or breaking, but I swear that like everything they have announced for the next major update so far has had some substantial issues with it. And it's pretty telling too with the next dev blog they released on the new M1A2 that apparently is just nothing like what the actual variant is, and they're just adding it as basically what they said on the dev blog there, but we'll get to that in the next video. It's quite surprising to me that they're making such big, cool future, more present time additions to the game, and they seem to be fucking it up, each one of them so far. So we'll take a closer look at the vehicle, though, but for aviation fans, you've got a new F-15, a new American jet aircraft for three different nations, if you are a fan of either of, or any of those three nations, at the very least.